What is your reading on AI, its implications, and how it can be integrated into this journey?
If you talk about AI in context of enterprise and just beyond just the generative AI, because in context of AI or context of enterprise, it'll be some kind of a combination of generative AI or artificial general intelligence or business artificial intelligence, whatever word you want to use, but it's a slightly different problem in a way, or a statement there. So think about it. I think a lot of the AI and the context that the AI will need is going to come from the data that is housed in these data stores, right? And I think we always talk about this idea that data is a constraint for AI. I believe there is actually one more constraint, and actually that may be even bigger constraint, and that is our ability to train the data. And that is a bigger constraint because our data was not designed to be trained. Our systems were not designed to be trained. And we just talked about the fact that this vocabulary definitions are missing, or they are inconsistent, or they are not, or they are duplicative or redundant in multiple places, right? So with lack of that interpretation, the language where we can understand the cause and effect of this data across the data elements is going to become a big constraint in my view, right? So so now the question is, how do you kind of build this, what I call as a teaching muscle or a training muscle for the organization, where we not only have to think about how do we use the data that we have today and overlay this vocabulary and use that to train, but also part of this is, do we have humans in the organization who understand the data, who can train the data, as an example, right? So it's not just a system or technology problem, or just the training from data and or data or systems training the systems. It's actually human training the systems also. Do we have those humans, and do those humans are available, and are they in a cross-functional context? Goes back to the same fundamentals that we just talked about. So I think this is where I like, I think what we just talked about, which is the semantic model or semantic layer that we are kind of talking about, is every organization will need it in some form or fashion, right? And the ones that have it in a more mature, more durable, more consistent way are the ones who are going to have the right framework for training the data. It's almost starting point. So if I have the right semantics, I have the right definitions, I have the right cause and effect and the linkages between the data, that will become the source, that will become the raw material to actually, to train the data, to create that interpretation for and to build these language models that we need for the enterprise. So I think, to me, we have been talking about data, we have been talking about data dictionaries or semantics and ontology for years. And enterprises have tried it, larger the enterprise, more complex the enterprise, they've tried it. It's been always been kind of incomplete, or it happens only in one silo or the other. It's never really comprehensive. I think now if the organizations really want to use artificial intelligence where they can use the data, their internal data in context of the external data and in context of the generative AI to bring that kind of picture, I think they will now be forced, and I use the word forced means they have to now have some semantic modeling in some form to be successful.
No, this is yes. I think it's a very broad topic because, you know, we use the word AI to mean a lot of things these days, and it goes from our typical deep learning models all the way to we're talking about generative AI and LLMs and then you have the whole robotics and all of these. So it's a very broad term. But I think in the specific context of what you're saying, I think one of the attempts that we did, which was an early experiment in TADA, was we said there is content and there is context. And content could be a piece of data. But what makes that powerful is the context, which is the description of the data. And the description is very often not You know, I might have a customer, but and a social security number, that is content. But minute I take that information and look around him, and I know that he lives in St. Louis, and he is working here, or he has moved from here and he has a family with three kids. Now that is context, and the learning or the information about the data is actually when you enrich the content with the context. I think that's where you were going.
Yeah.
And that is when the data gets trained. So what we found is content combined with context, the more that synthesizes, the more knowledge and wisdom you can get out of it. I think that's...
Yeah, and we can take it one more step mm-hmm. further, which is there's a context, which is the immediate context, but this context has to connect with other contexts
mm-hmm.
to create a real, full
correct
view. And this is where you start to turn this kind of
truly
an intelligent outcome out of this. So then question becomes, okay, how can we train that? What can we do? So one of the things that I would do is right now is to say any system that you're purchasing, you're building, you're designing, from starting today, we had to ask this question. Whatever system that we're building, the data that we're building or the data model that we're building, is that data and the data model trainable in the future? So there's just no way we should be building systems now onwards that are not trainable.
Right? Yep.
And then second is, in my organization, do I have the resources, the framework, the routines, the processes to train the data and systems? Who's going to do it? Who has that knowledge? Who I can not only build the context, but connect the context across these different entities?
No, I think that's a very, so both from a system standpoint and a process standpoint, you're saying that the future is not about the data, but about the ability to enrich the data and train it. Similarly, the processes that are able to do that. It's almost like you're going from a data organization to a learning organization. And
I would actually say it is more of a teaching organization. Mm-hmm. And this, there's a little nuance to that.
Yeah.
So think about what, if you go back in the history, most of our systems that we have built last century, mostly, they were largely designed to do. Take action A, it will have an output B, and it'll continuously and repeatedly do that. It was designed to do a task, right? And then slowly we started to build what we call as machine learning, which is the ability to analyze and analytically start drawing patterns, and based on those patterns you draw some inferences, right? And take some decisions. I think we have gotten to the third pillar, which was really important and missing in this intelligence cycle, as we call it, which is the training or the teaching. So the idea is to do, learn, teach. Now we have added the third pillar. And I think the point is most of the organizations are missing the third pillar. And it's not training in a training sense. It's truly creating this teaching muscle in our people, in our systems, in our data. Because that's where the game is. Whoever can take their own data. It's different that we can buy the data from outside and we can buy all the well-trained data from outside. But the challenge is going to train our own data, which is, as you rightly said, that is the vocabulary that only we know.
And makes every company unique.
Yeah. So I won't be able to train it unless I know what the dictionary and the grammar of my business is.
Yep.
Right? And to answer the question is then, who is going to define that dictionary? Who's going to define that grammar? Who's going to define that language of this semantic model of my company and my data? And then it's not like one-time thing, obviously, because we keep adding data sources, we keep adding new processes, we keep adding new capabilities. So it has to be an established capability where there has to be either group of individuals or a set of skills that has to be taught to existing individuals, where we have to get into this business of understanding the data, the context, connecting the context, and then turning that into training. So yep. Then becomes durable, and that turns into something intelligent.